Welcome to my channel. I'm Brittany, aka Whimsically Britt, and my motto is come with me if you want to live. So I just wrapped up my three-part series on Berlin. It was a video that I took back in, it was a trip that I took back in May of this year, and I ended up breaking it down into three parts just because it would have been entirely too long. I think in total it was about 50 minutes between the three videos. I also found that it helped to kind of build momentum for me as a new YouTuber. So first of all, thank you for everyone who has watched the videos, who's liked, commented, and most importantly, subscribed to my channel. It means so much to me as I'm trying to build this channel up. And I realized as I was making these videos just how hard it is to make videos, right? I mean, I've always kind of known just by doing some research and listening to other YouTubers. You know, they're taking 8, 9, 10 hours or, you know, what so have you to do their videos. And yeah, it definitely is. It's pretty tough, but I enjoy it. Other than having to search all of my, you know, my iPhone videos and downloading and cropping everything. But I think the more creative stuff I'm definitely enjoying. Anyway, all that is to say that in doing those videos in three parts, it really helped me to kind of build that momentum, releasing part one and seeing how you guys reacted to it. And then, you know, thereafter releasing the second and third parts. So this will actually be a sort of part four video to the Berlin videos. So in part three, I talked about getting into one of the most exclusive clubs in Berlin, if not in the world, and that is Berghain. The part three video also includes the Sunday market at Mauer Park, a DJing master workshop that I took, and three amazing restaurants that I tried. So do go ahead and watch it because there's tons more to do in Berlin outside of just visiting Berghain. I talked a bit about the do's and don'ts of actually getting in, and I realized I didn't talk much about my experience inside of Berghain. That was sort of purposely, so if you remember in that video, or if you didn't see that video, go ahead and watch it now. But yeah, if you remember that video, I only had one picture outside of Berghain, and that's for a reason. So yeah, I only have one picture outside of Berghain, and that's for a reason that I'll get to in a moment. But yeah, this video will be to talk about my entire experience from start to finish.
Plus another tip that I forgot to share in the last video.
So with that being said, let's get to it. All right, so first of all, Berghain is open, I believe, from Thursday night till Monday morning, like nonstop, 24 hours. Actually, let me backtrack. I think it's open from Friday night to Monday morning, nonstop, 24 hours. When I looked up the hours recently, like yesterday, it's open on Thursday night, but it is closed on Friday during the day, like between 5 a.m. and 10 p.m. It's not open. Don't quote me. Go ahead and look it up yourself before you go. But safe bet is definitely Friday night through Monday morning, nonstop. You can go at any time. That's like 7 a.m. on Saturday. That's 10 a.m. on Sunday. You can go at 3 p.m. So I think first of all, be strategic about what time you're trying to get into Berghain. Obviously, you know, Friday night, Saturday night are probably going to be the busiest times, and you will be waiting in line for what I hear is like 2 or 3 hours. You can imagine just because there are a lot of tourists that are traveling during that time. I actually ended up going on a Sunday night at 9 p.m. If you look back at my part one video with my techno painting teacher, she gave me a lot of tips on clubbing in Berlin. And she told me that a lot of locals do go to Berghain on Sunday nights. So anyway, I went on Sunday night and I didn't wait 2 or 3 hours. In fact, I only waited 10 minutes to get to the front of the line. If you looked up any videos on Berghain, yeah, you'd know that is like crazy. So I even had to like, you know, look around and make sure I was at the right entrance. Is this really it? So yeah, that's one tip. Try to go at a time that's not super crowded. Another tip about Berghain. So it is one of the most exclusive clubs in the world because the bouncers are extremely strict. So here are tips for you to make sure you're not turned away once you get to the door. So first of all, when you're in line, don't have your phones out. Don't be taking selfies, don't text, don't just keep it in your pocket to be safe. Another tip is if you arrive in groups or in a group, split that group up into 2 or 3 people per group. They typically don't like groups for some reason, is what I hear. And I think I witnessed that for myself. I told you in the last video actually that the group in front of us got turned away. They were a group of about like 5 or 6 people, and they were quiet and everything, and I'm not sure exactly why they got turned away. In fact, the bouncers didn't really say anything. They just kind of like, you know, told them to step aside, and yeah, they shooed them away. Okay, another unspoken rule, which is an understandable rule, is don't go in there, you know, looking drunk or being belligerent, again, being loud. It's best off to just be quiet. And I know you might be thinking, like, is this a club or a library? Like, why is everybody so hush-hush? But I kid you not, that line was so quiet, you could probably hear a pin drop. So, you know, if you want to be that one to talk, and that's on you. But another thing, everyone in line was wearing black, so that's sort of the dress code. You'll see lots of leather, fishnets, you know, kind of a BDSM vibe. Not quite as extreme as another club. I think it's Kit Kat. Shoes, black, you know, kind of like Doc Marten type shoes or combat boots. Definitely casual, so you don't want to go wearing heels or like a mini dress. Tons of makeup and all that stuff. That's definitely not the crowd there. So funny enough, my friend and I were the most colorful two of the bunch there. So I actually had a colorful floral kimono underneath my leather jacket. That kimono was inspired again by my techno painting teacher from part one. Just in case we didn't get into Berghain, we could have gone to Sisyphos, and she mentioned that that was a good, she showed me an outfit of hers actually, and she had a nice little kimono like that. So I picked that out actually at the flea market in at Mauer Park on Sunday. And my friend actually had on a red, like Hawaiian style button-up t-shirt and or a collared shirt, and he had white sneakers on, which is also usually a no, I guess, but somehow we got in that night, so thank the techno gods for that. Lastly, here it's good to know some German and to know what DJ is performing that night. I knew neither, and the bouncers really didn't ask anything, to be honest. They just took our IDs and let us in, so that was pretty cool. I still am trying to figure out why. All right, so let's move on ahead to what happens once you get inside. So once inside, you're gonna pay 25 euros per person. Also, they're going to put stickers on all of the cameras on your phone, on the front and back cameras. You cannot take those off. If they catch you, you know, taking pictures inside a Berghain, you will be kicked out. So please be respectful of that. The idea is to foster an environment where people can kind of just be free of judgment and really, you know, immerse yourself in the moment, you know, not be on your phones, not, you know, the typical, unfortunately, it's a very American thing, just like partying with your phone out and stuff like that. So that's a huge no-no in Berghain, and they make sure of it. All right, so what is the vibe like? So once I got into Berghain, it was really cool. So apparently Berghain used to be a former thermal plant. So it was very industrial, lots of concrete and steel beams. There were multiple floors. I believe there were 3 floors. It was very spacious, lots of space to walk around. I think again, because I went on Sunday night, it wasn't super crowded, which was great. There were a lot of places to sit and lounge about, a lot of different types of seating between like bench and like different chairs and stuff like that. There was only one dance floor where it was really crowded, and that's where the DJ was. That's where you'll be like more body to body with people. So after my friend and I, you know, roamed around for about 30 minutes, you know, exploring the place, we found some people to sit down with and kind of chit chat. Like there was one guy who was just on one of the benches, like just leaned against the wall with his leg up and whatnot, and we sat down and talked to him, and you know, he was a local there in Berghain, or in Berlin. In fact, everyone we talked to that night were from Berlin, which was pretty cool, and it kind of solidified that fact that my techno painting teacher, her name's Dina, by the way, Dina's statement that locals go on Sunday night. So talked to quite a few locals. They were pretty cool, pretty calm, chill vibe. And
don't get me wrong, it was chill, but it was also really loud, and we had to yell in order to have these conversations with people.
Oh, last thing to note is if you do not like cigarettes, like if that, the smell of it bothers you, and or if you're very sensitive to it, this might not be the place for you. I'm not sure if other clubs are like this, but When I left, I reeked of cigarette smoke, like my hair smelled of cigarettes, and I had a really bad cough. Well, not a really bad cough, but an annoying cough for like a full week. So yeah, be conscious of that. Oh, finally, actually, I think I said finally before. Well, finally, beware of other substances other than alcohol. So, I mean, you might know this about Berlin in general, but you know, people do a lot of hard stuff, apparently. So don't be surprised if somebody offers you something, you know, in the bathroom or, you know, wherever. You can politely decline, nobody's gonna get upset, they're pretty chill. But again, I think that's part of, maybe that's part of the reason why you can't really have your phone down and stuff like that. So yeah, if you're pretty, you know, if that bothers you, you probably don't want to go to Berghain. And actually, to be honest, it sounds like our night at Berghain was much more tame than the things that I've heard. I've heard a lot of interesting things go down in there. So my overall impression is that I enjoyed myself greatly. It was a great way to like really immerse in that techno culture, see the locals and how they spend their nights out. The music was pretty cool. I will say if you want to get a taste of like what Berghain is like, you might go on Instagram and see, like go to Instagram and look up Berghain, like the location tag, and look at the stories there. You won't actually see inside of Berghain, but some people do record like just the music through the phone, like with the stereos covered, so you won't see anything, but you'll hear the music and you might see some lights pulsing in the videos. So final impressions, I had a great time, and I definitely want to try to go back again, just mostly to see if I can get in once again. So what about you? Have you wanted to go to Berghain? Have you been to Berghain? What was your experience like? Were you rejected? I'd like to know, so let me know in the comments. And that's it for now. And if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the like button so that I can make many more videos. I have a lot more amazing, interesting travel content to share with you and tips as well. Thank you for watching. Until next time.